Hi. At first, I was playing Super Mario Land some years ago. Okay, so you should know what it was. I'm a Super Mario experience in a way that I can play it on all devices I have. And the problem is a JavaScript array and a level of that. So it's very easy to change the level, to create new levels, things like that. Tiles tab, so that's the original Super Mario graphics. And see, for example, the hashtag have you had in the finish picture on position 5 and 0. That's awesome. This is the result from the text file you just saw. It should look very familiar to you. It's the original clone of the level of Super Mario Land. The next thing I had to do is are the characters, the player. So they have to be animated. They have to be movable. I'm creating the player graphics from another tile set like that. So I created a Geeko. So when you move the player, it iterates through those graphics. When you're jumping, it takes the graphic on the right. So this is how I added some physics to the player. It's very important to have a smooth gaming experience. You need the gravity and the velocity of the player. So this is a simplified code snippet from that part. So if you press the right arrow key on your keyboard, the player will move to the right, and with the adding some velocity, so it's not just you click on it, he's on his top speed, but he's getting faster. Same when you jump, you get a boost to the top, and then the gravity comes in. So this is a live demo part of the player movement. You can see I added some debug values, so you can see which sprite currently is displayed, which speed the player has, and which X and Y coordinates he currently has. So I can move him like that. You see, it's iterating through this graphic, so it looks like he's moving, and he can jump. And you see how it's using the different sprites. And that the speed is not always, so it's speed is at 6 after 1 second. The next thing I needed to add was scrolling. So we have now the background rendering, we have the movement of the player there, and now I need to add that player on the background and scroll through the level accordingly. So I just added some clouds so you can see scrolling. So it scrolls to the end of the level and then it stands. You can see the X position on top, so it's the maximum. So the level not only consists of the background, the player, but it also has some special objects, like the enemies, like the water, where you fall dead, like those blocks which are blocking player moving, like those special blocks with the question mark, where you can get some coins. Those are also done from the sprite set. And with that special object, I have to check for collision with the player, because when he collides with the enemy, he will die. When he collides with the wall, he has to stop. or when he collides with a coin, he has a score. So that's a simplified version of that part of the code. I'm just doing some rectangle about that special tile and check for a collision with the player. You can see it's very simple. It's just checking the X and Y coordinates and if it's in the range of some special other object. Now I have to put all of those things together to have a playable game. So it's a classical game loop. At first, I'm drawing the background on the current scroll position. Then I have to update the characters depending on if they are currently moving or not. Then drawing the elements or updating the elements when something then drawing out. At last, I'm drawing the controls. So that was this debug output or the score output. The next thing I added to be able to play that on mobile devices was touch controls, because you don't have a keyboard to press the arrow key. So I have some code in there checking for a mobile device and then dynamically adding those arrows on the display. So you can play like that. Another thing I added was a simple menu that's just the CSS menu where you can start or level. Another nice thing is that it's very easy to add a different theme to the game, because the Super Mario version I could not publish because I don't have the copyright on those graphics. So you can just replace the sprite images and have a complete new theme for your game. You can, and that is a part of the level definition, so you can just write there which theme to choose. So now we have it together, and I can show you the result. So I'm playing the special OSC level of Gikoran. Well, so done. And I can also show you the clone with the Super Mario level 1, so it's like the original. So, well, not exactly, it's missing some small features, but so that's it from my game. Maybe someone has a question or someone wants to play one level.
The graphics were with a canvas or a JavaScript library?
Sorry?
The graphics, you made them pure JavaScript or did you use Canvas or any standard JavaScript library?
It's in this piece of code. So it's painting on a canvas element in the HTML and reading the graphics from PNG files.
Other questions?
Someone wants to play.
Anyone? Want to play the game?
Come here. Okay. Okay, so thank you.
Thank you.
Ah, ein Potenzial. Ja, ich bin ein Potenzial. 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 Ich bin ein Potenzial